YongQiang loves his grandpa.
He is especially interested in whatever his papa is doing on the farm.
Whenever I pick up a tool, he tries to pick up the same tool. When I ride my bike, he rides his bike.
It always put Grandpa Ming on edge because his grandson is deaf. He and his wife have been raising YongQiang ever since the boy's parents decided they couldn't handle his disability themselves.
He was always in danger. All I could do was use hand gestures, which didn't work. He runs all over the place, but I'm old and can't keep up with him. Once he got hit by an electric bike.
The driver kept honking. He didn't know YongQiang was deaf and couldn't hear him.
He recovered, but the problems continued at home.
He just got mad when we wouldn't give him what he wanted, and he would shut himself in his room. He couldn't tell me what was going on in his heart, but I was afraid he might kill himself someday.
Poor little boy. How would he find a job? He'd be a beggar.
The Mings saved all their money to buy YongQiang used hearing aids and put him in language school. But things didn't work out the way they'd hoped.
He couldn't hear at all. The teacher said he couldn't stay in school without hearing aids. If he missed this window of opportunity, he'd never be able to speak. His life would be ruined.
The couple kept asking people for help and coming up short. Finally, they were put in contact with CBN, and we gave YongQiang brand new hearing aids.
Now he can hear everything and even corrects me when I make a mistake. He can hear cars honking and he's made friends. YongQiang has changed so much. He feels loved and not rejected.
Every time he learns a new word, my heart is very happy. Without the hearing aids you gave him, he would never be able to hear or speak. Thank you so much for bringing sunshine to our family and for giving my grandson a bright future.
Thank you, CBN.